Welcome to Mac and PC Prime Video. For you, I am Ramanujam. Let's put together a fantastic video editing PC build and talk about it. Core i7 Ultimate Edit PC Build 2022. Some potential Rocket Lake leaks have surfaced with benchmarks featuring the Core i7 11700 Kelvins pitted against current top CPUs in a variety of games and tests. The original source, Lab501, via video cards posted the benchmarks for the 8-core, 16-thread CPU, this morning as a preview, on. In PC Mark 10, the Core i7-11700 Kelvins is marked as having achieved 7927 and sits sandwiched between the company's own Core i9-10900 Kelvins, with 7904, and AMD's Ryzen 5600X, with 8018. And in FireStrike Extreme tests, the 11th gen chip holds a score of 16,572 for the graphics test and 15,844 in the general test. In both cases, it trumps the Ryzen 7 5800X by a hair and falls just short of the Ryzen 5 5600X, though it puts up a good fight. The chip was also tested for relative game performance at 4 Kelvins, 1440p and 1080p. With the overall results rounded up by the following statement. In fact, in several other games listed, the Intel Core i7-11700 Kelvins surpasses all the processors, altogether topping the benchmarks in half of the game tests listed. Touted as Gigabyte OAC motherboard, entry-level Z590 models, both the Z590 OAC and Z590 OAC share the same PCB, and as a result, follows the same black and white design. This includes a black and white printed PCB, with black heatsinks and a slim rear panel cover. The Gigabyte Z590 OAC includes Wi-Fi 5802.11ac support, with both models including 3 PCIe M.2 slots, 2.5 gigabits Ethernet, and advertised as having a 12+1 phase power delivery. Both the ultra-durable OAC models include 2 full-length PCIe slots, with the top operating at PCIe 4.0x16, and the second at PCIe 3.0x4, and a single PCIe 3.0x1 slot located at the bottom. Bordering on one of the most basic models of any Z590 board announced so far, Gigabyte includes one PCIe 4.0x4 and one PCIe 3.0x4 SATA M.2 slot, with 5 SATA ports with RAID 0, 1, 5, and 10 support. 4 of the SATA include right-angled ports at the right-hand side of the board, while a single straight-angled port is located in the bottom right-hand corner. The Z590 OAC and Z590 OAC include 4 memory slots with support for up to 128GB, with Gigabyte not unveiling the maximum supported speeds at this time. The only difference between both models is the inclusion of a Wi-Fi 5C NVI on the AC model on the rear panel. Both models include 2 USB 3.2 G2 Type-A, 4 USB 3.2 G1 Type-A, and 2 USB 2.0 ports, and omits any kind of Type-C connectivity, likely to save on costs. A single DisplayPort video output, 3 3.5mm audio jacks, an unspecified 2.5 GBE controller, and a PS2 combo port finish up the rest of the rear panel. Gigabyte also includes a nice metallic silver I/O shield. Deep Cool GAM Max L240T Blue 240mm LED all-in-one liquid CPU cooler with dual chamber pump. Intel processor socket LGA 2066 2011 V3 2011 LGA 1200 1151 1150 1155 1366. Out of the box you have the main AIO design, which, as you might expect, has a 240mm radiator and pump head. At a glance, it all has a dark black design. When you look at the details, however, you start to see some of the more interesting aspects of the design. Let's take a closer look. The radiator is designed for 2x120mm fans to be installed, hence making it a 240 AIO liquid cooler. In terms of aesthetics, there's not much to talk about here. It's black, has no branding, and looks fairly standard to most radiators. The pump block is undoubtedly where things start to get interesting. As seen in many Deep Cool designs, it carries a circular shape with the Deep Cool logo to the top. As you might have guessed, the silver areas are where some of the blue magic happens on this cooler. The contact plate has a nice large square design, which should provide some excellent coverage for the vast majority of processors, be it Intel or AMD. It should, of course, be noted that this AIO cooler is neither suitable nor compatible with HEDT processor designs such as the AMD TR4 Threadripper, as the DeepCool GAM Max is a 240 design. You are provided with two 120mm fans. Sorry if that sounded a little obvious. Both of these are DeepCool designs and ones in which we have seen on prior AIO coolers released by them. Aesthetically, with the lights off, there isn't much particularly remarkable about them with the exception of the rippled effect to the fan blades. This will, presumably, play no small part in the blue effects when the light show starts. Thanks for watching. Please like, share, and subscribe.